I think this painting probably has more resonance now than it even did in the moment. It was the year of the London Olympics, and the Diamond Jubilee was a really crazily festive occasion. Every day there were images of the Queen with a big smile on the front page. And so I wanted something which had a completely different note, sort of a moment of pause, a moment of reflection. I was given 2 nights to spend in the Abbey on my own, which was remarkable. The very spot where she was crowned, this central circle on the Cosmati pavement in Westminster Abbey, which is this incredible mosaic on the high altar of Westminster Abbey, where the throne is physically placed and the crown aligns with this central circle on the ground to give the monarch divine power. It's like the epicenter of the British monarchy, where for 900 years every monarch has sat there on that very spot to be crowned. So it was an imagined moment, because you never see the Queen on her own in a public space. So the sitting took place in Buckingham Palace in the yellow drawing room. Determining what she would wear involved quite a lot of discussion with the palace. And everything was run by the Queen, apparently. So she was wearing the robe of state. It was incredible. I mean, this thing weighs a ton. You need 4 people to carry it in. So I was told that she could stand for a part of the sitting, but not the entire sitting. At the moment that you begin the sitting, there's a term that I was told to use, which was pretty remarkable. It was, "May I take control now, ma'am?" And I was just could not believe that that's what I had to say, literally. And in the moment, I couldn't bring myself to say those words. You know, it's like saying, "Can I take control of the country?" You know? I had this vision of representing the Queen in a very introspective mood. Obtaining that was a real challenge because, you know, it's a little bit difficult to explain to the Queen that you would like her to look a little bit somber, right? I found that there was some resistance from palace staff on the day of the sitting, and the Queen's dresser was quite adamant that she should be looking up and looking quite cheery. Yeah. This is a painting twice as big as anything I'd ever tackled before. You know, this is the largest official portrait I think ever painted the Queen, and the scale was, for me, was relevant, you know, for the impact of the work. I wanted the viewer to feel as though they were standing in presence of the Queen, to get that sense that they were right before her and that they could almost walk into her space. She has this extraordinary aura. It's a little bit hard to see behind the mask, but I did see someone who I felt, what I was impressed by was this sort of sense of humility that she had. And that really did inform the painting. I only had 6 months from the moment of the sitting to the unveiling of this painting. So the pressure was on, and I ended up working about 20 hours a day. If you take an X-ray machine to my painting, you'll see there are many different, you know, ideas that I tried out and painted over and over. So, you know, to get to a sense that, you know, this felt like it was living and breathing as the Queen herself, it was a real wrestle with the canvas. 3 weeks after it was unveiled in Westminster Abbey, after the Australian exhibition run, it was actually vandalised. Someone came in with a spray can in their coat and started to write the words "help" on the painting and was tackled to the ground in rather dramatic fashion. The pee kind of ran off the edge of the canvas. But instantly a team of restorers, you know, with cotton buds, for, you know, 5 weeks, day and night, were cleaning this painting until they removed all the spray paint. And I just did a bit of painting over to touch it up, and it was all perfectly restored. The Queen notoriously doesn't comment on any paintings, but I got very, very positive feedback in that immediately after the painting was finished, I got a commission. I did a portrait of Prince Philip in 2017. And then in 2018, I painted the Prince of Wales at the time, now King Charles III. I found her to be really an incredible person, very thoughtful. I think you'll make a great king, actually.